All right, so we're gonna change gears. On the count of three, one clap. One, two, three. All right, here's the story. We are going to have this discussion that I absolutely love. This discussion is called technique versus intensity, but really, the lecture is the technique lecture. And this is one of those discussions that we absolutely have to have because what we find is that people totally misunderstand this program. And what this discussion does is it helps kind of shift some mindsets about what we think is important and what we're really after. And so hopefully this will bring some clarity to some of the discussion that you may end up with when it comes to people discussing these movements and workouts and things that we do. I started the weekend off and gave you the definition of CrossFit. Somebody tell me, what is the definition of CrossFit? There's no test, so it's cool. I heard variance, good. Okay, so we'll put that out here. We'll say constantly varied. What was the other piece? Functional movement, love that, uh-huh. And high intensity, good, that is exactly it. Remember, that is the description or the definition and the dose that we give people. We give them constantly varied functional movement at high intensity. What we hope to achieve by doing constantly varied functional movement at high intensity is this thing called fitness. And Jen gave you a definition of fitness. What is that? So close, yes. If you say that, it would be work, right? Here it is. Increased work capacity across broad time and modal domains. Iwa kab dab tamam, something like that, right? Increased work capacity across broad time and modal domain. And now what we find is central to being able to increase your work capacity across broad time and modal domains is your ability to refine the movement pattern or to do them correctly. And so we could have two axes up here. We could put one here and one there. And here's what we're gonna do. On one side, we're gonna write energy expenditure, okay? Energy expended. And down here on the bottom, we're gonna put task accomplishment. And so what I could do is I could have an athlete that is trying to get, I don't know, to a store. Anybody familiar with this area where there might be a, like a great rest, what was it? Bodega. No, the bodega, all right, let's go to the bodega. What? Tell me what happens at the bodega. You can get ice cream, you can probably get some cafe con leche, right? You might be able to get some pastelitos, right? Okay, there you go. So the bodega is where we wanna go, all right? The bodega, and I'm not sure if I spelled that right, is that right? Bam, all right. Now there's a couple of ways that we could get there. One of the ways we could get there is we could use the movement that we saw Qualik do earlier and the movement that we saw Art do earlier, okay? All right, now here's the story. We're gonna let you demonstrate it, sir. One way we could get to the store is by worming. So if you would please, just three quick repetitions of the worm right here. Whenever you're ready. One, two, three. Heck yeah, four. Ooh, that was, it was getting bigger as you went. I love that. Now, knee pads would be important to that for sure. Now let's talk about it. If we were headed to the bodega, and let's go ahead and say that that thing is a half mile away, 0.5 miles, okay? Now, how much energy are we gonna expend trying to get there? Oh, heck, but you better believe it. A ton of energy. We'll get there, but it's gonna take us a while to make that happen. That is the worm. The other option that we have is to literally walk out of the front door and continue walking to the bodega. Now, are we gonna use some energy doing that, yes or no? Yes, but is it gonna be nearly as much as doing the worm? No, and you're probably gonna save some layers of skin as well, right? So there we go, we're walking. So the difference between the two of these things right here is what we call technique, okay? And so, technique can be defined as the movements or positions used to accomplish a task. movements or positions used to accomplish a task. What good technique does, walking, it helps us minimize the energy expenditure for maximizing the task accomplishment. What poor technique does is it helps us be grossly inefficient and certainly maybe even take more time to be able to make that happen. When we start looking at the practice of these movements that we're going to be doing with you guys over the course of the 2 days, the idea is to make these things as smooth as possible so you don't waste energy or waste time with the movements, okay?